Can I help you with anything?
Can we talk about the Bull's charges?
Best company you'll find from here to the Anderfels. In my time with the Chief, we've gone up against everything from bandits to magic trees. We're expensive, but you'll never doubt we're worth it. Want to know anything in particular?
Do the Chargers specialize in anything from a tactical standpoint?
Bull doesn't want us large enough to work as an army. We're better as shock troops to skirmishers. We've got archers for hitting enemy infantry, Dalish with more archery, and Skinner and her people on the flanks. Rocky handles fortifications and traps, and Stitches keeps us all fighting. They mostly hold back. I'll lead the frontline fighters with Grim, and the Chief goes wherever he can hit something.
Are there rules for how mercenaries operate?
If you don't want some noble to treat you like bandits, yes. There's also a code of conduct most companies hold to. Keeps things civilized on the battlefield. We accept surrenders for ransom from mercenaries, nobles, and soldiers wearing a lord's colors. Our prisoners are treated well, injuries tended. We'd want the same for any of ours who got captured.
You said something about everything from bandits to magic trees. I'll admit to some curiosity.
Right. Sylvans. That's what Dalish called them. Apparently spirits can possess trees, too. Some noble in the Dales, and they really don't like it when you call them Dalish nobles, had a haunted forest. His family had abandoned the land, but he wanted it back. The Chief bought us all axes, and in we went. Between the axes and the torches, the Sylvans weren't too bad. Worst part was the squirrels.
We'll talk later.
What can I do for you?
Can we talk about the Bull's charges?
Certainly. What can I tell you?
Have you had any other interesting jobs?
Had one noble whose rival had been told by a fortune teller that her death would come on feathered wings. The noble sent us after the rival. Not assassination, legal and everything, but we had to wear feathers. We sewed them into shirts over our armor. Should have seen the Chief, all feathered up like the cock of the walk. Ended up retreating after all that. The rival choked to death a year later on a chicken bone.
We'll talk later.
Can I help you with anything?
Can we talk about the Bull's charges?
Certainly. What can I tell you?
Have you had any other interesting jobs?
There was the time with the spiders. Big old beast taking over some Navarran lady's winter estate. With a full season to lay eggs. Hanging from the chandelier, scuttling over the tapestries, women on the bath. Don't really have a story about it. Just a lot of spiders.
We'll talk later.
What can I do for you?
Can we talk about the Bull's charges?
Certainly. What can I tell you?
Have you had any other interesting jobs?
This Orlesian guy paid us to clear out some bandits who'd taken over his mine. We got in, took down most of them, and had just reached their leader when the mine collapsed around us. Turns out the bandits were working for the Orlesian guy, and he wanted to cover up their agreement. The bandits passed around shovels. We all got to digging. Tracked a lot of dirt into that Orlesian's bedroom.
We'll talk later.
What can I do for you?
Can we talk about the Bull's charges?
Certainly. What can I tell you?
Have you had any other interesting jobs?
We went up against Gatla's giants in Ferelden. Not actual giants, but big guys. All wearing a dragon's weight in armor. Might as well be fighting golems. The Chief challenged Gatla himself to a single combat. Gatla laughed and called him a horned savage. The Chief broke a dam and flooded the valley. Last we saw of Gatla was a bunch of bubbles as we swam away.
We'll talk later.
What can I do for you?
Can we talk about the Bull's charges?
Certainly. What can I tell you?
Have you had any other interesting jobs?
We had these villagers pay us with rice one time. Should have seen the Chief's face. Him and me and five guys defending the town from 50 bandits, and they pay us in bags of rice. Chief always took money up front after that. He also learned how to make this rice pudding dessert. It looks awful. It's pretty good.
We'll talk later.